Hello everyone. Today we're going to be talking about how to boot your Zybo app from the SD card. Now up until now in class we've mainly focused on loading the app into your board by using the USB during the debug stage. But this isn't very useful if you want to put your Zybo on something like a robot, or if you want the program to persist between power cycling your Zybo board. So in order to get our Zybo board application to persist, in order to solve these problems, we need to store our application in some of the Zybo's non-volatile memory. Now for our purposes, the application includes both any sort of software application, including the FreeRTOS, as well as the bitstream needed to configure the Xilinx processing system to run all of our custom hardware. So how do we do this? Well, it turns out that it's actually quite easy in the Vivado software suite. So let's say I have my Vivado software up and running with the FreeRTOS demo. All right, everything looks good. And in main selected application, I've selected one so that once we have this loaded on the board, we'll be able to connect to the Zybo and see the terminal come to life. How do we get this image onto an SD card? Well, first thing that we need to do is figure out which board support package we're using for our application. So if we look around at the includes down here, this tells us the name of the board support package. All right, so next thing we do is open up the board support package that we're using, go into the system.mss, and modify the BSP setting. In here, we have to check to make sure that Xil RSA is selected as one of the supported libraries. The reason for this is that when we create a boot image, Xilinx allows us to encrypt the image so that other people can't reverse engineer or do other things to it. And in order for this encryption to work, we need this library enabled. So select that if it isn't selected already, hit OK, and then Vivado should go through the process of regenerating the BSP sources and remaking all of your projects. Depending on your computer and whether or not you're plugged in, this may take a little while. Okay, the next thing we need to do is to create a bootloader. Now, what a bootloader basically does in our context is tells the Xilinx chip on the board where to look for the application, and it also loads the bitstream into the board to configure our FPGA. So creating a bootloader, or a first stage bootloader, is pretty simple. Just do File, New, Application Project. You can give it a name, First Stage Bootloader. Use default location. Check to make sure that we're using the right hardware platform, right processor, C language, that's fine. Standalone OS platform is fine as well. Board support package. Now we could create a new one, but because our project is already set to use an existing board support package, let's select that one. Click on Next. Then from the various templates that are available, we want to select Zinc FSBL or First Stage Bootloader. You can read the description here, but basically the FSBL configures the FPGA with hardware bitstream and loads our application, which is great. So hit finish. Again, wait for the SDK to do its thing. Okay. All right. So this claims to have generated some error. This is probably just a case where right clicking and maybe try regenerating the BSP sources could help. Okay, and that seems to have fixed everything, so once again we ran into some spurious errors, but just by regenerating and giving Eclipse a second try at everything, it seems to have resolved itself. It's not asked too many questions, nothing to see here. Yeah. Alright, but everything does seem to be working. So we can go on to generating our boot image. To generate our boot image, we select the software project that has our application in it, in this case, RTOS demo. Right click and click Create Boot Image. So this opens up a little wizard, Create Zinc boot image. Now it has the option to create a new BIF file or import from existing BIF file. I've already run through this, so I have an existing BIF file to import from. Could also create new. Either way, it doesn't really matter. Now we have the option of using authentication. Or using encryption in order to protect our bitstreams and application. I don't really care about that because this is all open source code anyway. So I'll just leave these unchecked. And if you look down here, you'll see that by launching Create Zinc Boot Image from your application project, it pre-populates this with a few things for you. So one thing, it pre-populates your bootloader with fsbl.elf. Then it also loads in the hardware design, design1wrapper.bit. That's our bit file. And it brings in the application file, RTOS demo.elf. Now from here, take note that it'll output a file called boot.bin in some directory. We can change the directory. Right now it looks like it's defaulting to where I have my FreeRTOS, so that's fine with me. From here we just click Create Image. Output file already exists at the specified path. Do you want to override it? This is because I've already created a boot image before. So just click OK to create the new boot image. All right. Now that that's done, open up File Explorer. And pull up your SD card. So first thing we want to check on the SD card is we need to make sure it's properly formatted. For this to work, we need the SD card to be formatted in one partition with a FAT32 file system. Now my SD card came like this from the factory. If yours did not, you can right click Format, choose the FAT32 file system, the rest of this is fine, and start the formatting. But since mine's already properly formatted, I won't do that. The next thing we do is we navigate within the SD card and copy that boot.bin file we just created onto the SD card. Now, once you have done this, the next step is to put the SD card into your Zybo board. And then make sure that on your Zybo board, these jumpers here are set to SD. This is what tells the board to boot from the SD card as opposed to the flash system. Right. So once the jumpers are set, insert your SD card into the board. You can plug the board into your computer so that it gets USB power. And so that you can communicate with the FreeRTOS terminal. Turn the board on. Wait about half a minute for it to boot up. And finally, we're going to connect to the board to make sure that the terminal is actually running and that everything works successfully.